President Trump. NBC's Bree Jackson reports.
Left Democrat investigator.
Former President Trump railing against investigators this morning.
Is just a continuation of the most disgusting witch hunt.
All eyes are on a New York City grand jury today after Trump predicted he'd be arrested in connection to alleged hush money paid to adult film star Stormy Daniels ahead of the 2016 election. Robert Costello, a key witness for Trump, testified Monday.
Michael Cohen told us that he was approached by Stormy Daniels' lawyer, and Stormy Daniels had negative information that she wanted to put in a lawsuit against Trump.
Cohen, Trump's former fixer, alleged Trump paid him $130,000 to buy Daniels' silence. Costello, who claims he was Cohen's attorney, attacked his credibility, but Cohen fired back.
Pretty much almost everything that Bob Costello said will be once again proven to be inaccurate as it relates to me.
Top Republicans coming to Trump's defense.
I believe is the epitomization of the weaponization of the federal government and departments against political opponents.
Manhattan's district attorney, Democrat Alvin Bragg, is weighing potential charges against the 2024 presidential hopeful.
I think if it's a misdemeanor, there would be more political consequences than legal consequences.
One question that could be answered today: will or won't Trump be indicted?
If the former president is indicted, sources tell NBC News that the Secret Service would accompany Mr. Trump throughout the process of possibly surrendering and making an initial court appearance, and do so while trying to keep him out of public view. In Washington, Bree Jackson, NBC News.
Well, a new program will make it faster and easier to use SNAP benefits in Louisiana, as the state is one of five chosen to be part of a pilot program from the USDA Food and Nutrition Service. SNAP Mobile Payment Pilot will let those that receive SNAP and DSNAP benefits access EBT benefits as soon as they're approved. The Department of Children and Family Services is looking for retailers who would like to help put this program into service. According to a news release, the new technology would allow EBT benefit recipients to use mobile payment methods like tapping or scanning their personal mobile device. Well, the Salvation Army of El Dorado wants to ensure school children receive meals during spring break. Volunteers from around Union County helped prepare over 1,200 sack lunches on Monday before getting in the hands of local youth in need of a meal while at home for spring break. The Army says this week they are delivering meals to 10 locations in southern Arkansas. The locations range from Norfolk to Huttig and many areas in between. If you know of a location where children are needing a meal, reach out to the Salvation Army of El Dorado at the number listed on your screen.
Now, Storm Tracker Doppler weather with meteorologist Trey Tonneson.
Well, things are changing around the country atmospherically, as they usually do this time of year, fairly quickly. Out on the west coast, our next weather maker is just now taking shape in the form of an upper level low that's moving on into the coast, eventually drive some rain down into the south and east. First, we're seeing some rainfall that'll move through parts of central and northern Arkansas today, but most of those showers should stay to the north of our area. On into your Wednesday, this particular system starts spreading that rainfall more to the easterly direction and more towards the east coast. But as for us, we'll start seeing our rain chances increase into Friday. In fact, Friday, the largest by far chance to see rainfall and some thunderstorms this week. But taking a look across the country, you'll notice those showers move in the easterly direction. Pretty easterly pattern throughout most of the week. As for temperature highs today, into the upper 60s, noticeably warmer, and the term noticeably warmer definitely applies to both your daytime hours and nighttime hours, as temperature lows will be into the upper 50s tonight. Noticeably warmer certainly applies to both daytime and evening hours, but temperature is going to be warmer and winds going to be slightly breezy across the area. Monitoring the next potential for severe weather development on into Friday, showers and thunderstorms possible, the cold front that'll move through. Not a lot of cold air behind this, so the potential for severe weather development is a little bit up in the air being so far out right now. But temperature is definitely warming up this week compared to last. Biggest chance for rainfall, and really the only one, Friday.
Well, that's it for your midday update. NBC News Daily continues.